Everything seems to be working. Hey guys, how are you doing today? I hope you're doing well. Happy Thursday. I just wanted to pop up and do a quick update for you all, a little episode. So welcome to everybody who's new and welcome to all of you returning subscribers. If you don't know, my name is Kayleen and my neighbor is leaving, so hopefully you can't hear that, but my name is Kayleen, and I'm the principal fiber artist and yarn dyer behind Littlebean Crochet. Littlebean loves hand-painted yarn. As always, I will put my information up here on the screen for you. You can find me most places as Littlebean Crochet. On Facebook, I am Littlebean Crochet Shop. And we also have a Ravelry group, which is the Littlebean and Me podcast group. So you can just search Littlebean and Me in the groups tab for our podcast group. So welcome. I hope that the audio sounds good. I just got a new microphone, so I'm hoping that it's a bit of an improvement from what we had. Have a little noise cancellation, make it sound a little crisper for you. But anyways, welcome, welcome. Happy sunny day. Today's quite sunny. I was actually going to try and film yesterday, but it was a bit of a tough day with the kids, and it was not exactly conducive to filming outside. It was quite dreary. The light kept changing a lot. So today we have a nice cloudless sky, and it's looking quite sunny and beautiful. So I have a few things to touch upon. First, I am actually at the same time, hopefully both of these videos are up at the same time, but if they're not, I'm going to put a little eye in this corner of the question and answers that you guys put in my last podcast episode. So thank you for everybody who submitted a question. Anybody who's ever asked me a question, I'm always happy to answer them. I hope you like them in a separate video. I know that some people aren't really, are not really into listening to me talk and ramble about questions that other people are curious about, especially if it's not something that you're interested in. So I hope that it is okay in a separate video. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you like that video, give it a thumbs up. Let me know if you'd like them together in the same video or if you don't mind them separately. I don't know if you can hear Cece coughing in the other room. anyway, So if you want to see that, you can always click the eye up here and it'll take you right to the video that we did the Q&A for. So today is Thursday. Tomorrow I have a big update planned for the shop. I am doing a launch with Sunshine and Bubblegum for our self-striping sock kit, the Fleur and Feathers kit. Yes, Cecilia.
Can I have some crackers?
You want some crackers?
Yeah.
You have some crackers in the living room. Mommy gave you some.
Huh?
Yep. I gave you some already. Okay, so I'm doing a big shop update tomorrow with Lynn of Sunshine and Bubblegum. We're releasing the sock kits that we've been working on. It's a self-striping, three short stripes. It's called Fleur, and her contribution is, don't cover your ears, please. Her contribution was beautiful project bags, and her sister also made us some lovely lobster clasp stitch markers. So, excuse me. I hope you guys all enjoyed that. It comes out tomorrow at 1 p.m. Excuse me. Mommy's speaking. Can mommy finish? Thank you. It comes out tomorrow, which is Friday, the 31st of March. At 1 p.m. Eastern time. So if you're in a different time zone than me, you can just Google what time is it in Boston, and it will tell you what time it is where I am, because I'm in the Boston area. So if there's ever a question about when something goes up, that's always the best way to find out. So that's all I had for administrative stuff. So now let's get into some crafty things. I have a couple of crochet things to talk about today. One is a work in progress and one is a newer project that I was testing out. And yeah, I don't have any knitting, just crochet. So let me grab that. Okie dokie. So we are back, and okay, Cece has her crackers again. She second snack. Sorry for the interruption. But anyway, let's chat about some crochet. So I did make some progress on the simple scallop shawl that I showed you last week that I was working on an elder tree. So I was very smart this time. I put a progress keeper in. So Here is where I was last time. You can see it right there. And I've made maybe 3 more repeats of the pattern. So it is slowly growing and growing and growing and growing. I have this much left, so I think I'm just over the halfway mark in terms of how much yarn I've used. But this is coming along nicely. It's a bit mindless. I've had to take a pause on it though because Tucker decided it would be a great idea to take my crochet hook and throw it behind the sofa. So I'm going to have to dig out behind a sectional, get my crochet hook back. So that's fun. And then the other project that I was working on was this one. So I posted on Instagram yesterday. I was looking for something a little bit different. So I started working on this shawl. This is not going to be a full-size shawl. This is actually just a test crochet to see how it works up. So this is my Exploding TARDIS colorway. There you go. So it is a pooling color. One end of the skein is a TARDIS blue, and it fades into a yellow with orange speckles. The speckles are not that strong in this skein, so that's part of the reason why I kept it. And then this is what it crochets up. So this is a Tunisian project, a Tunisian crochet. And it begins, this is actually the center, this triangle. So this was one repeat of the pattern here. It is called une manière de faire, I think that's it. And it is a pattern that's up on Ravelry in Tunisian crochet. I bought a few patterns from this designer, Une Manière de Faire and Une Autre Manière de Faire, where they're right now on sale. So if you put both into your cart, one of them is free. They're the same price. So it's buy one, get one free. But it's a Tunisian pattern. This one is a triangle shawl. And I believe the other one is a square or a rectangle, kind of like stole or shawl. But I really wanted to see how this yarn would work up because I knew it was going to pool and then intentionally, unintentionally stripe. These are very bold colors. These are not necessarily my colors. But yeah, it's working out up quite nicely. So it's pretty much a 10 stitch pattern. If anybody has done the 10 stitch afghan, that I think is a Tunisian pattern as well. But you're working these short rows back and forth and shaping the shawl that way. So right now I'm down at the bottom here, going to make my final pass up this side. So this point here, get it. It's just crochet, so it's gonna have a loose end. So this point here is going to be the bottom, or the furthest most point, and it's going to work all the way out to here. Doing a horrible job showing you guys, I'm sorry. If you look at this, you'll know what I'm talking about. So it's the long part. So I'm starting the long part where I start down here and I work all the way up, and then I do some decreasing and shaping that way. So there's a pattern that I wanted to do that in Tunisian. It was called Entre les lignes, and it means between lines. It's another pattern by the same designer in Tunisian crochet. These patterns are all available, by the way, in French and in English, so the English translations are great. They're just fine. I haven't had any trouble working with them. But I was thinking of maybe doing a Tunisian shawl along or something like that in the next few months. If anybody's interested, Tunisian crochet is a really nice melding, some may call it the evil stepchild of crochet and knitting, but it's a nice melding of types of techniques. This has much more of a knit feel. It has the characteristics of knit fabric. It's much more flexible. It sits very flat, and the way the colors work up, it works up a lot like knitting. So this was what I was working on yesterday in anticipation that I want to cast on a larger shawl in Tunisian, the Entre les Lignes, which I will get to in acquisitions because I had to buy some hooks. So that's what I had for crochet. Again, I don't have any knitting. I haven't really had much time to knit these past few days, mainly because I've been doing a lot of dyeing. I had some bigger shop updates last week, which went really well. So thank you so very much to everybody who came by on Saturday to the shop and did a little shopping, either for yourself or someone else. I've had several people who've been shopping for their Fiber Share buddies. So I hope you guys all like your yarn. And then even if you didn't, if you've shared, liked, commented on any of my things, I really super appreciate that. The community that we're building here is such a special and wonderful community, so I just want to say thank you so much for nurturing and loving this channel as much as I love this channel, and also on Instagram as well, sharing, liking, commenting, all of that just helps to build and foster a really positive community, so I really appreciate that so very much. Okay, so let's get into acquisitions. Okay, so acquisitions. I did have a couple things arrive just today. So one of them, or a few things. So one of them is the new microphone that I have. It's sitting right here, kind of maybe a foot from my mouth. Hopefully the audio is sounding good. It is a Samson C01U Pro microphone. It's the same microphone that I got for my brother for Christmas, incidentally, or for his birthday last year, something like that. He is a Twitch streamer, and he was in the market for a new microphone. So that's the one he wanted, and that's the one I purchased for him. And his audio sounds great, so I was like, well, I'm going to just buy myself the same one because I know it will work well. At least I hope it does. This is the first video and experiment, so I hope you're liking it. And I hope there's a bit better noise cancellation of background noises and such, because it's a microphone. Usually microphones will, you know, only take in sounds that are so close to the microphone and not necessarily, you know, all of the things that are happening like in the living room or outside. So anyway, so that was my first acquisition, but I can't really show it to you because I'm using it, so I'll just put a picture or something what it looks like. But I have two other acquisitions. One is crochet related and one is spinning related. And so for all of you spinners who've been so patient, I've been fiber poor since the last spinning update where I spun and knit a hat in a couple days. That was the only fiber that I had, so I have some fiber to show you. Okay, so I apologize for any crinkling that you might hear. Everything is still in packaging. I'm not going to pull things out, but I'm going to be very careful. So I wanted to show you first the Tunisian crochet hooks that I purchased. So I went on Amazon yesterday and I ordered my microphone, which is here today. And I also ordered these Dreams, Nurse Pride Dreams Tunisian crochet hooks. I'm apologizing for the glare. It's very glary. These are a set of crochet hooks. I believe it goes, from E through L, US size E through L, which is a 3.5 millimeter all the way up to an 8 millimeter hook. Most commonly used crochet hooks in like general crochet. Most crocheters work with fingering to worsted weight, so this kind of covers all of that ground for me, so I was very happy to do it. I also have other Knitter's Pride sets, so I know that the cords are going to be interchangeable even with my knitting needles. I have the Carbons interchangeable set. And I also have a large gauge Dreams knitting needle set, which is, I believe, 13 through 15 US size knittings. So I know all of those will interchange, so that's another reason why I got the Dreams set. And I'm sorry for any glare or crinkling. I'm going to try not to do that. So you can see it goes from smallest to largest. And this is a Tunisian set, so these have an attachment and a cable that goes on, and you put a stopper on the end of the cable, and you can do long rows of Tunisian style crochet, which is kind of like knitting on long circular needles. Each row in Tunisian is a forward row and a back row, so you are building your row and then closing all your loops. So it's kind of like picking up loops in knitting. So like if you're doing a knit stitch and you're putting all of those stitches onto your needle, but then you're closing all of those stitches at the end. So you go all the way down your row, picking up stitches, and then returning, you are closing off all the stitches. So it's a really interesting and fun technique, which is why I thought maybe we could do a Tunisian along. If you're interested in that, leave a comment below, but I'm definitely going to be doing it regardless for my own personal pleasure, and also to experiment with some colors and using colors. There are some techniques in Tunisian which I'm kind of excited about, and it's almost like a brioche, so it's like crow knitting almost, where you're using a two-sided crochet hook, and you crochet down one way with one color and crochet back the other way with the secondary color, and it ends up being a lot like brioche. So I'm looking into trying to figure out how to do that with what I have. I feel like I'm saying a lot. I'm very conscious that there's a microphone in front of me right now. Normally I'm just talking to the camera because the microphone is up on the camera, but looking and like seeing this microphone right here is kind of like, I don't know, it's like off-putting. So yeah, so that's what I got, the first thing. And then the second thing is a fiber. So these were from Snurve Yarn. She had an update. This is Bren Boone's shop. She doesn't go through Etsy. She goes on her own website, which I believe is snurveyarn.com. But I snagged two braids of Polworth and Tussa Silk. It's an 85-15 blend. It's not in superwash. And what I thought would be beautiful is taking these and making them into one long gradient. So these are kind of dyed in a gradient manner where they slowly transition from one color to the next to the next. And so both of these braids share a similar pink tone. It's not exactly the same, but it's enough to be able to blend the fibers together to create a seamless integration. So I could do a full two skein shawl in a gradient with hand spun, which I thought might be nice. So my plan is to spin this as thinly as I can, Navajo ply it to maintain the color transitions. But yeah, so this one is I'm sorry for the glare, purples and pinks melding into some lighter blues, melding into some sand gray, kind of like a grayish or a putty type color, which is quite nice. And then this one is much more vibrant. This goes from a yellow into some blues and then into some vibrant pinks and purples. So I'm liking this. I'm very excited. I love the packaging on this because I can just drawstring these closed. I don't have to figure out a different way to store my fiber while I'm working on it, because sometimes folks don't put them in a bag like that. It'll just be wrapped up with the band. But for fiber, I really enjoy that type of packaging. So those are the acquisitions that I have, and I'm very excited to start spinning because I know I need it. I need some like zen time where I don't really have to think about what I'm doing actively. I can kind of just do passively spin and just be happy and work on that and not worry about anything. So I wanted to show you the stuff that I've been working on this week. I haven't done a lot of heavy dyeing, but I do have a new colorway that I put up in the shop earlier this week just as a casual drop-in as part of a dye-along. And then I have the self-striping yarn, which is going to go live tomorrow. And I also have a few sets of the Burrow Mini Skein set and Sparkle that are just going to go up in the shop. I had a custom request for it this week for one set, so I just dyed up a full 5 sets of it. And I will just be putting the remainder in the shop. And I also am rounding out 900 subscribers here on YouTube, so I do want to do a giveaway when we hit 1,000 subscribers. I think that would be really fun. And I started kind of stockpiling some things, you know, little trinkets. Obviously, yarn is going to be included in this giveaway. I think I'm going to have 2 winners. But as soon as we hit 1,000 subscribers, I'm going to make a thread for the Ravelry group and make it live. So I want to show you those things right now. There's a crinkly plastic bag down there. Just ignore that sound. I apologize for it. I will edit it out. I have an armful of yarn, so I just wanted to show these things to you before anything else. So this is the Burrow. This is a mini skein set. This is still up in the shop as dye to order, because it's easy enough for me to do tonal mini skeins and also to just dye up a bunch and put them in the shop as, you know, a few extra sets. This is especially this color because this color is one of my most popular colors. So it is a nice maroon, an aubergine, a black charcoal, depending on the dye lot, a sand color, and a peach color. And I think these all go together quite nicely. It by far is the most popular tonal set that I've done so far, and I really like it. So some of these are going to be in the shop probably later tonight or tomorrow during the update with Fleur. So that's that. Then here is Fleur again. So Fleur will be up tomorrow. This is a 3-stripe self-striping yarn. They're narrow stripes, so they're 2 to 3 rows a piece. And it goes from a deeper, kind of a navy, greenish navy, or like a darker navy, to a light blue-green, to this kind of strawberry or like a warm orange-red. So those are the colors. These seem like they're coming up pretty true to life on the camera. So these will be dropping at 1 p.m. with the bags and the stitch markers. These are all also coming with an undyed mini skein. So I think the price point that we are putting them out at is $55, which I think is a fair price for the yarn. It's 120 grams total of yarn, a bag, and a stitch marker. So if you're interested in that, 1 p.m. tomorrow, they will be in my shop, and they will also be in Lynn's shop. There are going to be 8 available in each shop. So if you go to one place and it's sold out, come to the other place and see if there's any more left. But we did put them in both shops. And then the last thing that I worked on this week was a new dye. So in one of my yarn groups, they do a weekly dye-along where everybody who cares to posts a picture that is for inspiration for dyers, and the one that gets the most thumbs up is the winner for the week, and all the dyers who like to participate and dye the color. So I'll put a picture here of the color, and this I called Beau Baton, and I started out with doing the lilac, the gray, and then the blue, which are pretty much direct from the photo, the same type of colors, shades, tones, the whole nine. But I didn't really like it, so I added some teal. I thought the teal added a lot of interest. So yeah, I named these Beau Baton, and they're just nicely speckled yarns. They have a lilac type purple, which is a nice kind of blue tone purple. It does break a little bit blue, so there's purple and blue speckling where that tone is. We have some teal, and kind of this, like a primary blue. It's not too warm or too cool. It's just a primary blue tone here. And then some gray speckling. So it's very interesting. I really like it. I think this is a fun spring type color. Makes me feel very happy inside that I dyed something new and created something beautiful. So I did put these in the shop already. So if you are interested in them, I have some on Everyday Sock, Luxe Sock, Sparkle Sock, and Simple Sock. All in sock. I have barely dyed on any worsted, and I have a ton here to dye. So next week's update is probably going to be a lot of worsted weight and DK weight. So that, my friends, is that. So now I wanted to talk about the giveaway. So we are really there. We're almost at 1,000 subscribers. I feel overwhelmed and very thankful and a bit scared that there are so many people potentially watching. Last week's episode garnered about 600 views or so, and that's a little, I never thought that so many people would care to hear what I have to say, or care what I worked on, or anything. I just make this for fun, and to kind of keep myself on track, and give you guys another way to see things that are being done in the fiber arts community. So I'm just very, very thankful and very happy that you are enjoying this time with me, and that you're liking it so much that you're subscribing and coming back week to week. So thank you to everyone who is new or old, who comes back or decides maybe this channel isn't for me. Any person who interacts on this channel is being thanked. anybody who comments or likes or shares, subscribes or doesn't, it doesn't matter to me, as long as we're building this wonderful community. So thank you so very, very much from the bottom of my heart. I've never seen such generosity. I had a girl, Ashley. I gotta get that. Ooh. Okay, so sorry about that. It took me a little longer to find. It was literally right here in this pile of stuff that I've now eventually tossed and tossed and tossed. But I wanted to show these. So I feel so incredibly humbled to be able to do this. And without you guys like, I would still be doing this, but I feel like growing a community is so important, and, you know, it just makes me happy to know that people are connecting through my channel and are sharing common interests, and, you know, there's so much generosity that comes out of this group that is, it just blows my mind. So one of the things I wanted to share, and I've gotten to know so many of you well through Instagram and also chatting through Facebook or, you know, even right here on YouTube, and I was gifted something. I'm just so overwhelmed with the generosity that comes out of this community. I have been sent things previously. I shared the little crocheted sock that was crocheted by Love Knots by Cheryl. She sent that to me as a token of gratitude. I've been gifted stuff by my friend Clarissa Beth, who is Crochet Cakes here on YouTube and on Instagram as well. So we've sent each other parcels, you know, gifts from the mainland to Puerto Rico and vice versa. And so I received this gift from Ashley. Ashley, her user, she said I was able to share. So her user on Instagram is AshKnitsAnything, and she is an American living abroad. She's part of a military family, and she purchased some yarn. I'd sent her some samples, and she purchased yarn for me, and she said to me, you know, I really want to send you something as a token of gratitude because of sending her samples before she purchased. And she's like, I really want to send you something. So weeks have gone by and I hadn't even thought that she was going to. I said, you don't have to send me anything. You do not need to send me anything. She said, no, I insist I'm going to. I went to my post this week. I picked up my mail and I was like, what is this? Who is this from? And I look and it's from Ashley. She sent me 2 project bags. So Ashley, these are absolutely beautiful. She sent me 2 kind of project bags or cosmetic bags. These are made out of a canvas material, I would say. These are canvas, a very not too heavy canvas. It's like a moderate weight, but it is like owls and wildlife, and then this speckled thing. I don't even know what to call this. It's like confetti. That's the word I'm looking for, is confetti. And a small one as well. Both have a gold zipper. And then she also sent me a small note, which was quite lovely, and a couple of mushrooms. I'm like, you can't see. There are little mushrooms. Let me take them out. Again, I apologize for crinkling. A couple of progress keepers. So she said I was free to keep or give. And I think what I'll do is I will keep one and I will give one. I am not in need of 2 project bags, though I would like to keep these both. Nor am I in need of both of these stitch markers. I am very happy to share one. They're actually progress keepers. They have the little lobster claw. So I'm thinking that I will give this small project bag away as part of a giveaway, and I will keep the larger project bag for my soon-to-be Tunisian shawl. And I will include one of those small stitch markers. So Ashley, she said I could share her information, so I'll put it again on the screen. AshKnitsAnything. She doesn't have an Etsy shop. She shares family photos and things like that, but she is looking to begin her own business, and so I wanted to share these with you as a lovely shout out. These are very high quality, very well made. The stitching is very nice. The material is very durable. So definitely recommend, go check her out, go follow her, go say hi. She's a very sweet, sweet girl. So those are from Ashley, and this small one will be part of the 1,000 subscriber giveaway. So maybe I'll have 3 prize winners. I'll have one of Ashley's bags and some more of this stuff. So I'm going to grab all this stuff. I'm going to pause, take things out of the plastic bag so that they're not crinkling everywhere, and kind of give you an idea of the things that I've been picking up and the things that I want to include in the 1,000 subscriber giveaway. Okay, so As many moms do, I frequent Target, and I find a lot of really cute things, and I wanted to pick up some stuff that not necessarily was, like, knitting related, but things that were really cute for springtime, things that I could include in a giveaway, along with yarn that could either be used, you know, in fiber arts, so for your knitting, crochet, spinning, weaving, whatever you do, or, you know, for your own daily use, or for your kids, or for whatever. So I picked up some of these notebooks. So these are the moleskin notebooks. These are lined, I believe. Yes, these are lined journals. They're this purple color. I think it's like an aubergine, kind of like the color I'm wearing, maybe a shade or two lighter. But these are ruled journals. These are similar to what people use to bullet journal, but these are lined. I also picked up some for myself. This one is my dye notebook. So I have been updating my dye recipes, reorganizing my dye recipes, because my original journal is totally ruined, and because I use it all the time, it's out. So I wanted to buy some of these to include in the giveaway. So those will be in the giveaway, along with some pouches. So I have a couple styles of pouches. So these are clear. These are these are just plastic clear pouches. I thought these would be wonderful for notions, especially if you're like me and you forget what goes in what bag. They're long enough for crochet hooks. They're long enough, you know, to include stitch markers and scissors. You can even probably put a full-size pair of scissors in this if you wanted to. So I was going to make a couple of packages, like prize packs. So I'm going to show you multiples of things, but they're going in different prizes. So just keep that in mind. Like, one of each will go into each. Does that make sense? Then I have a couple of these pencil cases. This one is pink with gold speckles, and then this one is just all gold. It's a lot of gold. I thought I was on a gold kick. These are pencil cases, but again, I think these are really great for notions. this one is obviously a touch bigger, but again, serving the same purpose. And then I found these in the dollar section of Target, and I thought they were so stinking adorable that I needed to include them in the giveaway. So of all the prizes as well is a little bit of stationery. So these are just pencils that have sayings on them. These say, work hard, play hard, let's make plans, out of office, kind of like fun little puns. But there's some sticky notes and then some blank note cards that I thought were wonderful for spring. I really liked the colors. They made me happy. So again, these are going to go as part of the giveaway. And I thought they were really useful if you are sending a gift to someone that you've knit or crochet, to have these note cards and pencils. I love stationery. I don't know about you, but I love stationery. I didn't just buy one moleskin journal for myself. I bought 10, because I like them so much. Is that a problem? I probably shouldn't do that. But to be fair, some of them were on clearance, so let's just leave that there. My husband will also use them, so let's just put that out there as well. But I do have a little problem with stationery, and I like to collect it, and it just makes me happy. I don't know, it's one of those things. So anyway, I am very excited. I'm going to be putting those things in for the giveaway. I will include that small bag also from Ashley in the giveaway. And then all those things are kind of stacked very perilously right here. But on top of all those things as well, I would like to include some yarn. So the little prize packs will include a full 100 gram skein of yarn as a thank you and a token to all the subscribers who are here, who come back, who are new, anybody who's enjoying the content here. I want to say a huge thank you. So once we hit that milestone, get ready, because I'm going to do the giveaway and it's all going to be ready to ship stuff. Nobody will have to wait for me to do anything. I'm literally going to have things like ready to go in the package, pre-weighed, ready to hit the door. So So yeah, that's about everything for me today. Just a reminder, I'm going to have the shop update tomorrow, which is for Fleur and Feathers. That will be at 1 p.m. Eastern time. And then also, I'm going to link here the little doobly-doobly-doobly-doobly-boop. Excuse me. In the little thing up there for the Q&As. So if you wanted to watch that as well, you could always go over there and watch it. So anyway, I hope you guys have a wonderful weekend. We're getting some awful April Fool's weather. It's supposed to snow again, whoop-de-doo. But I hope that you guys do enjoy and are able to get out and have some fun this weekend. Relax, knit, do whatever makes you happy. Yeah, that's really about it. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you next time. Bye!